Hello guys. Welcome back to iLane channel. Code signing of iOS apps is one of the hot topics for every iOS developer. Although, there are multiple resources available online, as well as Apple's clean documentation on the code signing process, it's still a mystery. Before we jump into Apple's way of code signing iOS apps, let's explore what code signing is in general. In real life, we sign different contracts, agreements for various things. Why do we sign those contracts? What does a signature mean to us and why is it important? It's simple, because signing contracts protect us legally, and we trust that the terms and conditions in the contracts cannot be altered, whilst the contract is in place. The signature also ensures the security that the contract comes from trusted authorities, and not from scammers. Signing contracts gives us security, safety, and trust. Similarly, code signing is the process of digitally signing any form of code, to confirm who wrote the code, and guarantee that code has not been changed or corrupted when it was signed. The code signing uses a cryptographic hash to verify the authenticity and integrity of the software code. In the software world, code signing ensures the identity of the author, integrity of the code, build system, and versioning, so that users of the software feel secure and safe while using them. Code signing uses various security terms like a public key, private key, certificates. There are different approaches to code signing used on different platforms, for example Linux, Windows, macOS. There's a lot of pieces involved in this whole process. We won't cover all of it for sure. We'll cover some of the most important user-facing tools and scenarios. The end goal of this whole thing is that, once you get stuck, you get going faster. To start off, the whole story starts with the certificate sign request. In public key infrastructure systems, a CSR is basically messages sent from an applicant to a certificate authority, in order to apply for a certificate. This uses public key infrastructure policies to create, manage, and distribute the digital certificate. The process of creating a CSR is very standard in the PKI. The applicant has to generate the public key and private key in the local machine. The applicant then attaches the public key with CSR, along with details like email, country. The applicant keeps the private key secret. The typical information required in the CSR includes the common name, organization, organization unit, country, and email address. The CSR contains the certificate request information, signature algorithm, and a digital signature of the requester to prevent requesting a bogus certificate. The certificate signing request is the process of requesting the certificate from the certificate authority, which is Apple, so that Apple can verify the details of who is requesting an issue of the developer certificate, if the details are correct. The requests have to be created from a local macOS machine. As an iOS developer, you must have created certificates by yourself at least once, and stored them in the keychain. You probably never looked at it, until your Xcode tells you that your certificate expired. It's important to understand the certificate's contents, in order to understand the code signing process. Now, let's dive deep into certificates. The certificate is at the core of code signing in iOS apps. Let's forget about Apple certificates and get into real life. When you finish university or some professional course, you get a certificate. You then attach that certificate to your CV or LinkedIn profile to show that you are trusted by some authority, that you have completed that program and you have knowledge. The employer is then impressed and offers you the job. Certificates are more powerful when they are offered by popular trusted authorities. If you get the certificate from London Business School, Oxford, or Cambridge University, then people trust you more. Basically, it's the same concept in the iOS or Apple world. In the iOS world, you get the certificate from the trusted authority. Certificate authority, which is Apple certifying that you are a legitimate developer of apps. You also paid Apple to get a membership with Apple Developer or another similar program. Apple has verified that all the information provided is correct and issued you a certificate to build awesome iOS apps. Getting the certificate from Apple isn't a big thing. You just have to pay them enough to get those required certificates. However, understanding the details of certificates and why we need those certificates are definitely a big thing. Apple has 10 different types of certificates. Each certificate has a different purpose, but there are two main certificates, the development certificate and distribution certificate. Basically, the certificate has all the data that we have provided while creating the certificate signing request. Apple then adds some signer data like authority, expiry date. The whole certificate has the signature attached to it. In the keychain application, if you right-click on the certificate and get info, you will see all this information. It should have the following things. Subject name, This contains user ID, name, organization details, and the country name of the developer. Issuer name, this contains Apple details like authority, organization unit, that has issued the certificate, and expiry date of the certificate. Public key info, this contains details of the public key, like which algorithm and signature are used. Finally, fingerprints, it contains fingerprint details like SHA-256 and SHA-1. The certificate also shows what this certificate will be used for, like code signing or any other activity. Now we will cover some important concepts specific to iOS, provisioning profiles and entitlements. Historically, provisioning profiles are considered the most painful things in the iOS code signing process. Before we go into the details of provisioning profiles, let's understand some terminologies and concepts that we need to know to understand the provisioning profile. The things we must know before we understand provisioning profiles are Team ID, Bundle ID, App ID, Device ID, and Entitlements. Team ID. The Team ID is a unique identifier for each development team. You can find the Team ID in the Apple Developer Portal, in the Membership section. Bundle Identifier. Every iOS app requires a unique identifier, so that the app can be identified without ambiguity. Every iOS app must set a unique bundle identifier in the reverse domain name of the company or individual. The bundle ID can be set up while creating an app in iTunes Connect, which needs to be used in the property list file of the iOS apps. Each target in the iOS app should have a unique identifier. App identifier. Generally, the app ID is the combination of team ID and the bundle ID. It's very common these days that a team can develop more than one app with different bundle identifiers. The app ID can be used to identify one or more apps. The team ID is supplied by Apple, while the bundle ID search string is supplied by you, to match either the bundle ID of a single app or a set of bundle IDs for a group of your apps. The app ID has two types, single apps and the wildcard app ID for a set of apps. Device ID. Every iOS has a unique identifier also called UDID. With UDID, each iOS device can be found uniquely. Basically, UDID is 40 characters long number made up of the combination of numbers and letters. Like devices, each simulator also has unique UDID. We can find device UDID by attaching the device to Mac and with iTunes. Entitlements and App Sandbox. iOS apps can't do everything on their own. We have to explicitly tell the app what app can do, or cannot do in the form of entitlements. The app is entitled to do certain things that we need to define in the App Sandbox. The app restrictions are managed by the sandbox. The App Sandbox is a different infrastructure from the code signing infrastructure. Code signing is responsible for running what's inside the sandbox. The app entitlements are configured to specify which resources of the system that app is allowed to use and under what situation. Entitlements also confer the capabilities and security of an iOS app. The resources that the app is allowed to use usually have some default values, but they are always disabled. The app developers have to enable them explicitly. The entitlements values that are commonly used are a cloud, push notifications, Apple Pay, App Sandbox, and more. We can enable the entitlements in the Xcode Capabilities tab for a specific target. You should only enable those entitlements that you need. This prevents malicious code from entering the app. There are some restrictions on entitlements that you only use for debug builds, for example, Get Task Allow is only allowed to run an app that is signed by a development certificate. This entitlement is not allowed for an app signed with a distribution certificate. Provisioning profiles. At this point, you must be wondering why we need to know all the above things in order to know provisioning profiles. The short answer is, provisioning profiles are the combination of all the things that we have seen so far. Basically, it consists of everything from certificates, app ID, device ID, and entitlements. The provisioning profiles define the rule for running the app inside the device. Its role is to confirm that. First, it is a specific app with an app ID. The second, it is an app with an app ID that can run on certain devices included in the provisioning profile. The development provisioning profiles have the list of devices included, whilst distribution provisioning profiles don't have the list of devices. The third, the app only has those entitlements defined in the provisioning profile. Finally, the app can only run trust based on the certificate embedded in the provisioning profile. Nowadays, with the latest version of Xcode, all the code signing activities are handled by Xcode under the hood. We just need to specify the code signing identity and Xcode will manage everything for us. This approach is all right for development and distribution from a local machine, because the development team can rely on Xcode to handle all these tasks, and apps can be released from the local Xcode machine. However, in the modern era of DevOps and continuous delivery, we can't use local Xcode to ship applications. The applications have to be shipped from the continuous integration server. From this arises the need for automating the builds and understanding code signing in detail. We can look for the use with the command CoDesign, or another tool from the third-party side like Fastlane to automate this process regardless of Xcode. In Xcode, Xcode uses the CoDesign command line tool to sign the app when it's built. Well, to have a deeper understanding of how code signing works, please wait in our other videos. In the last part here, I'll give a summary of the process to create the necessary steps to Xcode in support of code signing. Firstly, use the Keychain Access app from your Mac to create a certificate signing request. Here, Keychain Access creates a public key and private key, then attaches public key and important information into certificate signing request. On the Apple Developer Portal, uses CRS to generate a certificate, download, and install it. After that, use your certificate you have just created and your app ID, device IDs to create provisioning profile. Download profile, import into Xcode to sign the app, and run on the real iOS devices. Well, here are the basic steps to code signing. It's my pleasure to get your comments or answers in the comment box. See you all in our next videos.